Blessed day, everyone. Welcome po sa ating daily devotions. And today, we officially start our study on the book of James or the letter of James. Sabi po natin kahapon, this James is the half-brother of Jesus Christ. And we said, hindi siya nagsimulang nananampalataya sa kanyang kapatid. And that is very important. From an unbeliever to now a believer of God, to now being a leader of the church, to one who is writing to a congregation of believers to encourage them as they go through difficulties, we see the power of the gospel to indeed save. Nakita natin kung gaano ka-humble ang mamang ito. Even though he was the half-brother of Jesus Christ, he calls himself as a servant, a bondservant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. We see there na nanampalataya siya na si Kristo nga ay ang Panginoon at ang Misayang hinihintay nila, ang tagapagligtas. And so, he is writing this letter to the 12 tribes, meaning it is written to the Jews, those Jews who has placed their trust and confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ. They are now Christians. And it reads in the dispersion, sila po ay nakalat. They were dispersed. Why are they dispersed? Again, marami pong nagsasabi na during the time na o pagkatapos na mapatay si Stephen, that's when the Jews, the Jews were scattered. But I think more than that event, it was God's providence that has dispersed these Jews para po lumaganap din ang Ebanghelyo ng Kristo Jesus. And so, why is he writing them? Well, he's writing them because they are being persecuted for their faith. And you need to also understand, ito pong sulat na ito ay probably the very first letter na nasulat sa New Testament. And so, here we see James writing to these believers. At yung theme po ng sulat na ito, kung titingnan natin, ay kung paanong mamuhay bilang isang mananampalataya in these various situations. And so, itong sulat na ito, nakita natin, isinulat ni Santiago or ni James para turuan, paalhanan ang mga believers na ito with regards to how they ought to live their Christian life. At napaka-practical po nito. Napaka-practical. And so, as we go to verse 2, we see a primary issue, a primary concern of everyone, believer and unbelievers alike. Sabi ni James, "Count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds." And so, what is James focusing on now? He began to discuss about trials. He began to discuss about testings. He began to discuss about difficulties and struggles and stress. Anong katotohanan na makikita natin sa talatang ito? What timeless truths and principles can we glean from this opening verses? Unang-una po, makita natin that trials, difficulties, struggles, stress, they are all predictable. Why did I say so? Sabi ni Santiago, sabi ni James, "Count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials." It doesn't read if you meet trials. So meaning, it's just a matter of when. It would happen to everyone. Right? At kailangan natin discuss din ito kasi may katuruan po na nagsasabi na pag naging believer ka na, wala nang problema. In fact, some go to the extent of saying, pag may problema ka, pag meron ka mga isipin, then maybe you're not exercising your faith. Well, here we see, it reads, when you meet trials. Meaning, ito po ay predictable. Sabi nga, di ba ni Pedro, when you face fiery trials, don't think that something strange is happening to you. Sabi ni Cristo Jesus mismo, in the world there will be trouble. But take heart, I have overcome the world. So, right off the bat, simulang-simula pa lang ang encouragement sa atin ni Santiago, encouragement sa atin ni James, is to expect hardships. Yes, of course, God in His sovereignty and His providence blesses us with a lot of things, and He solves our problems, He provides for our needs. But hindi sinasabi ng Biblia at never pinangako ni Kristo na pag nanampalataya ka sa Kanya, wala kang problema. Right? Because we live in a fallen world. We live in a fallen world where there is sin and there's diseases. And so, itong trials na ito, it will happen. It's just a matter of when. So, sa madaling sabi, predictable ito. We should be expecting these things. Kaya, importante ito. So, ang simula po na counsel ni Santiago sa atin, ang simulang reminder sa atin ni James is to expect trials. At yung trials po rito can be translated into testings of our faith, mga nangyayari sa paligid natin. At napansin nyo, various kinds. So, marami siyang shape and sizes. It could be a big, it could be something like as big as a life-threatening disease, or maaring financial needs, or maaring relational problems. So it can be various kinds. So hindi lang maliliit, hindi lang malaki, hindi lang isipin sa panlalapi, hindi lang isipin sa physical needs. It can be various. So, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials. Ang sabi ni Santiago, sabi ni James, trials, they are predictable. And they are problematic kasi maraming shape and sizes. Right? Pero, napansin natin, ang simulang-simula niya, it can be paradoxical. Meaning, you can look at it as a blessing. Sabi niya, count it all joy, my brothers. He's talking to his brothers in the faith. Brothers as a Jew, speaking to Jews. But brothers with regards to their salvation in Christ Jesus. Sabi niya, trial, very predictable. Very problematic, various kinds, right? Pero it can be paradoxical, or you should look at it in a different vantage point. You count it all joy. Consider it pure joy. Why is it so? Sabi sa verse 3. Bakit? Kasi trials have benefits. Trials can be productive. Right? So, nakita natin, trials are predictable, trials are problematic, various kinds. Trials can be paradoxical, it can actually create, and you should have this disposition na you consider it pure joy, and it can be productive. Productive in what manner? Because you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness. Diba, hindi tayo makakaranas ng steadfastness kung walang pagkakataon para tayo maging steadfast. If there's no need for us to be steadfast, hindi tayo madedevelop ang faith natin kung hindi tayo nai-stretch for us to just practice faith. Sabi niya, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness, and let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. Lacking in nothing doesn't necessarily mean wala kang pagkukulang. Ang sinasabi nito ay wala kang pagkukulang sa maturity. You may be perfect, you may be complete, you may be mature. Kaya simulang-simula ng sulat na ito, galing kay Santiago, sinusulatan ang mga believers who happens to be Jews, who are now dispersed, who are facing persecution and hardship. Sabi ni James, it would happen when you meet trials, not if. And when it happens, it can be of various kinds. It can be big, small. It's problematic. But take heart, you need to have a better vantage point, a better disposition. Consider it pure joy. Why would you consider that that as pure joy because it would be productive. It would develop your faith. It would strengthen your heart. It would strengthen your conviction. It would have its full effect and you will be mature. And you will lack nothing. Lacking nothing means you would not need anything else but God and His Word to face any and every kind of hardship. This is a very practical reminder coming from James to believers who are suffering. Kayo po, you may be going through some difficulties, you may be going through some rough times, you may be going through some trials. I pray that you would see that we live in a fallen world. So these trials are very predictable. We know that they can come in different shapes and sizes. They can be problematic. But if you have the disposition of looking at it from and through the lens of Scripture, you would know that you can consider that them as joy, pure joy. Why? It would be for your own benefit. Dito po nagsimula sa Santiago sa panulat na ito. Tomorrow, we'll be looking at the next section. But for now, I pray ito pong snippets, tidbits na reflection natin sa letter ni James ay helpful para sa ating lahat. Are you going through some difficulties? Consider it pure joy. Why? It would produce faith. It would produce steadfastness. It would produce dependence and adherence and obedience to God's Word. Right? Ito po ay magde-develop sa atin to be more mature in the faith. I praise the Lord for this teaching and I hope you were edified and I pray that the Lord was glorified. Sige po, manalangin tayo at magpasalamat sa Panginoon. Oh, loving God, we thank you for this very practical letter, this very helpful letter. Salamat po ng marami kung paano sa panimula pa lang po ay pinakita sa amin na we live in a fallen world. We live in a world where there will be trouble. Pero sinabi po ninyo, take heart, I have overcome the world. And this is one way, a means of grace for you to strengthen our faith. Kaya maraming salamat po. We can still consider it pure joy when these things happen. Not if, when they happen. And they will happen. Salamat na marami. Pwede kayong maghanda. Paano maghahanda? Laging manalangin, laging magsaliksik at mag-aral yung salita. And we pray that this would be real, Lord, in every person's life listening right now or tuning in right now. Marami pong salamat sa paalala. We pray that as we continue on studying this beautiful letter, it would be for our maturity and for your glory's sake. Marami pong salamat sa pangalan mo, Jesus. Salamat sa pagsami sa akin. I'll see you all tomorrow as we look at the next section. God bless you po.